For a while now, I've been trying to make money online by trying out many different side hustles. And after watching many Andrew Tate videos, I really like what this guy has to say. Andrew Tate is a former kickboxing world champion and is now a successful entrepreneur. And in today's video, I want to share my experience with making money online by freelancing and how I got started in Andrew Tate's the real world and on the freelancing campus. I'll also discuss the different skills you can choose, how much money you can make, and my personal journey trying to make money with freelancing. So let's get right into the video. The first thing I need to do is obviously join the real world, which costs $49 per month. And if you want to join the real world, you need to watch out, because there's many fake websites out there that look like the real world but are actually scams. For that reason, I'll be leaving the official link to join the real world down below in the description of this video. So this right here is the official website, and you will first see a quick 2-minute video basically promoting the real world and talking about how much money people can make with it. As you scroll down, you will see a bunch of testimonials from people within the real world, and then below that, they just show you exactly what you will be getting access to, as well as what money making methods they will be teaching you. I'm not gonna go through the entire website because it would honestly take forever. But again, if you want to check it out, the link is down below in the description. Anyways, I clicked on the join now button and put in my personal information. Then I paid the first $49 payment, which will give me access to the real world for 1 month. So once you join the real world, there are 8 different skills you can choose from. E-commerce and crypto, which I tried and made videos on before, copywriting and stocks, business mastery and finance, the UGC creator campus, and finally the freelancing campus, which I will be joining for today's video. Honestly guys, for $49 a month, you're getting a lot of value for what you're paying. The real world is a community of individuals who want to learn new skills. There are also individuals who want to network with like-minded people and start making money online. There are so many resources available, from courses and webinars to coaching and mentorship. Being a part of this community has helped me stay motivated and focused on my goals. The Freelancing Campus is a course that teaches you everything you need to know about freelancing. I spent a good chunk of time reviewing it and learning from it, and I can honestly say that it makes me feel confident that I can actually make this work. It covers everything from picking a skill and creating a portfolio to finding clients and setting your rates. The course is self-paced, so you can learn at your own pace and on your own schedule. I found the course to be really helpful in getting started with freelancing. Before we dive into my personal experience, let's first talk about what freelancing really is. Freelancing is essentially working for yourself and offering your services to clients. The skills you can choose within freelancing are endless, from things like writing and graphic design to social media management and even web development. The amount of money you can make as a freelancer varies depending on the skill, experience, and demand for your services. However, I do have some friends who are freelancers, and it's pretty safe to say that they earn a pretty decent income. But anyways, as for the skill I'm going to pick, I decided to focus on content writing. I knew I had a talent for writing and enjoyed it, so I thought it would be a good place to start. I learned as much as I could about content writing, including how to write for SEO. I also learned how to pitch clients and how to set my rates. After watching a lot of the freelancing videos on content writing or copywriting, I stayed persistent and kept developing my skills. Then I felt like I would be able to charge more for my services. After I picked my skill, which is copywriting, the next step would be to develop my portfolio. Within the real world, they teach you that developing a portfolio is an important step in establishing yourself as a freelancer. A portfolio is essentially a collection of your best work, and this would showcase your skills and expertise to potential clients. I spent some time looking at other successful freelancers' portfolios to get an idea of what clients were looking for and how to present my work effectively. I then created a simple website using Shopify to host my portfolio. I made sure to include high-quality images and descriptions of each project, obviously highlighting the skills that I used and the results that I achieved. I also included a brief bio and contact information so that potential clients can easily get in touch with me. Developing a portfolio was a time-consuming process, but it was well worth the effort. I then signed up for Fiverr and started offering my copywriting services there. However, I soon found out that Fiverr wasn't the best platform for me. I was not getting the clients that I wanted, and the pay was lower than what I was hoping for. The main reason for that is probably just because there's so much competition on Fiverr. So I then decided to try Upwork. Upwork is another platform that connects freelancers with clients all over the world. Unlike Fiverr, clients on Upwork are typically looking for more experienced freelancers who can obviously deliver high quality work in a short period of time. I started browsing job postings on Upwork and submitting proposals for jobs that matched my skills and expertise. I found that the competition on Upwork was less intense than the competition on Fiverr, and I was getting more responses to my proposals. After submitting about 12 proposals, I eventually landed my first project. It was a content writing job that paid really well for my first time doing it. I was able to communicate with the client on Upwork and discuss the project, as well as set a deadline and agree on the amount I would make, which was $300. And right as I was about to start working on the writing job, I remembered that ChatGPT is a thing. So I gave ChatGPT the exact details of what I need done for the copyright. copywriting project. And obviously it didn't give me exactly what I needed, but it definitely helped me save some time. It was a great experience and helped me build my portfolio even more. However, it wasn't all sunshine and rainbows because some complications started to appear. For example, as you know, I started off by taking Andrew Tate's freelancing course and then I tried my hand at copywriting. I had that first project that went well, but then after that, I never found any more clients. And this tells me that I may have just gotten lucky with that one project. So after facing the challenges of finding clients and making some money, I decided to explore other freelancing options to share my experience with you. After having some thoughts, I made the decision to return to the real world community and reconnect with the freelancing campus and members. This active community is filled with freelancers who are constantly sharing their experiences, insights, and success stories. It's a fantastic resource to tap into for guidance and support. The real world community and the freelancing campus have been extremely useful in helping me navigate the freelancing side hustle. I talked to other freelancers, exchanged some ideas with them, and got some information on the best services to offer in order to make a continuous income. Through conversations and discussions within the real world community, I discovered a few new skills that have been high in demand and proven to be sustainable. Having this knowledge, I decided to switch gears and try my hand at a new skill. And this new skill would align with my interests and had great earning potential. After thinking this through, I chose to dive into the world of digital marketing and specialize in social media management. With the rise of social media platforms, businesses are constantly seeking professionals to help them navigate the space and, of course, reach their target audience effectively. After I had learned my new skill set, I returned to Upwork, excited to explore new opportunities and land clients who were in need of social media management services. I changed my profile to highlight my experience in this area and began searching for projects that matched my skills. After putting in about 50 proposals, I was able to get involved with 3 projects. Let me share with you the 3 freelancing projects that I was able to secure on Upwork, which I will be working on over the next 4 months. The first client I worked with was a small e-commerce business looking to boost their social media presence. They needed a comprehensive social media management strategy that would resonate with their target audience and create a strong brand identity. This project required experience in content creation, community engagement, and targeted advertising campaigns, all of which I had learned and was confident that I can deliver. As a social media manager, my role was to develop and implement a marketing strategy for the client. I conducted extensive market research to understand their competitors and their target audience. Based on the insights I gathered, I created engaging and good-looking social media posts that showcased the client's products and unique selling points. I also focused on community management by responding to customer inquiries, as well as addressing feedback and having meaningful interactions. Additionally, I developed and executed targeted ad campaigns to increase reach and conversions. The project had a duration of 2 months, allowing for a good amount of time to execute the plan effectively. The client allocated a budget of $1,500 for the entire project, which was a fair reflection of the scope of work involved. Another project I landed was with a startup in the health and wellness industry. They wanted to build a strong online presence and attract a large following. Basically, they also wanted to increase brand awareness with their target market. In collaboration with the client, I developed a robust social media strategy that aligned with their brand vision and target audience. This involved creating a content calendar, outlining specific themes and topics for each week, and creating engaging and informative posts. I also found relevant influencers within the health and wellness niche and developed strategies to collaborate with them to amplify the client's reach. Additionally, I implemented community engagement tactics, such as hosting giveaways and running interactive campaigns. Given the startup's need to establish an online presence quickly, the project had a tight deadline of 1 month, which will require efficient planning and execution to meet the client's requirement. They did, however, recognize the importance of a well-crafted strategy and allocated a budget of $800 for the project, so they understand the value it would bring to their brand. Finally, I had the opportunity to work with a local restaurant that wanted to expand its online presence. They needed assistance in managing their social media accounts and implementing strategies to drive more foot traffic. To help the restaurant achieve their goals, I again developed a social media plan. This plan highlighted their unique cuisine and dining experience. I created visually appearing Instagram posts that showcased their menu items, specials, and events. Additionally, I engaged with the online community by responding to customer reviews and comments. To drive foot traffic, I implemented promotions and special offers exclusively for the restaurant's social media followers. This helped generate excitement and encourage customers to visit the restaurant. This project goes over the span of 3 months, which allows for continuous engagement and consistent growth for the brand's online presence. Recognizing the long-term nature of the project and the value brought to the restaurant, they allocated a budget of $2,200, which shows their commitment to invest in quality social media management. These 3 projects allowed me to showcase my skills in social media management. I delivered exceptional results and built long-term relationships with my clients. By providing quality services and meeting their specific requirements, I was able to make a good income and gain valuable experience in my freelancing field. So there you have it, my journey from struggling with copywriting to finding success with social media management on Upwork. It goes to show that sometimes exploring different freelancing skills and tapping into the right community can lead to new opportunities and better financial prospects. If you are facing challenges in your freelancing journey, don't be afraid to pivot and explore different skill sets. The freelancing world is constantly evolving from what I can see from the real world, and it's important to adapt and embrace new opportunities. I must say, returning to the freelancing campus and getting some advice from the real world community played a significant role in this success. The guidance and insights shared by experienced freelancers helped me make the right decision about my new freelancing skill, which was social media management. It's truly a supportive community where free knowledge is shared and everyone is invested in each other's success. Now, you might be wondering about the financial aspect. The projects I mentioned earlier allowed me to earn a total of $4,500 over the span of the next 4 months. This income provides me with a solid foundation to further grow my freelancing career if I wish to do so. However, it's important to know that freelancing income can be different for everyone, based on factors such as your skill set and experience. I would recommend finding a skill and continuously refining it and then seeking feedback from your friends. And stay updated with industry trends and stay competitive to maximize your earning potential. This has been both a challenging and rewarding journey. It's a testament to the power of exploring new opportunities, leveraging the support and power of a community like the real world, and obviously being open to change, which I did by trying out a different freelancing skill. That's all I have to say for today's video. If you found this information helpful or have any questions, please let me know down in the comments below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And if you got some value out of this video, make sure you watch the next one that pops up somewhere on the screen. Until next time, happy freelancing.